Now, we put out a tweet a little earlier, and we have a question for you. It goes like this. It says, how would you feel if your ex marries your colleague? And then we have this picture right there. Yeah. So there's a lot that's been happening on the streets of social media. And I know that Tokwe has got some more information about what exactly led to the trend and the hashtag.
I mean, it came up on social media yesterday. And I remember when the saga happened, I think a couple of years ago. And, you know, because of how Tonto is very outspoken, a lot of people didn't pay her any mind. But then it just came out yesterday, I think because of Valentine. And now it seems like Churchill is now married to Rosemary. I mean, there's been no physical proof, but that's what it seems like. And to be honest, I don't think it's my opinion because I just feel like if Rosemary and Tonto DK were not friends, then they're just colleagues. And it just so happens that your ex-husband is now married to this person. Two public figures, one was married to this person and now one is married to this person.
So let's see what the people think. And we have a tweet from @adorablebub. Says, good morning, guys. No hard feelings here. I would only wish my colleague all the best. There might be a few things missing. We couldn't compromise while I and my ex were dating. He probably found that missing piece in my colleague. So they are free to move along. That's such a sweet tweet there. @ChloramphLinks says, I'd feel like it could it be I that got the problem.
I found that very interesting.
That person is wise.
Yeah, exactly. I found that very interesting because
I don't know if that's a healthy way.
It's very healthy.
No, it's very honest. I mean, he's being honest. Did I have a problem? Was there a problem with me? Why I couldn't stick with this person?
But that's like equal to thinking you have mental issues.
No, it's just a simple way of introspecting and making you check yourself if you have certain things that need to be changed. Or you know, the two ways you can look at it. Actually, it's not all bad. Is my point.
I feel like, hey, if there's a breakup that happens, it's not your fault. Don't blame yourself.
How can you be so sure,
I'm just going to say don't blame
yourself. Wait, Tokwe, what were you going to say?
Go. I think it's very mature that someone would think that they could be the problem.
Exactly.
And if you're having a breakup, I don't think you should say that you are not the problem. If you were the problem, because there's always a problem that leads to a breakup or a mutual agreement. So if you think you're the problem, I think that's great so that you can actually work on yourself for the next relationship. The fact that it didn't work with this person does not mean that you're entirely a bad person. It just means that for this situation, you are the problem. So you work on yourself to be better for your next relationship.
Calling yourself a problem in itself is a problem.
No.
If there's something you need to adjust, it doesn't mean that you have a problem. It means you've made a choice to improve on yourself, not because you have a problem.
I see what you're saying.
You've chosen to
I understand what you're trying to say, but I think sometimes admitting or applying a bit of honesty helps the situation as well.
Okay.
Having that little hubris of pride on your shoulder and saying that I can't be a problem is a bit of a problem.
Okay. All right.
All right. But we can't
take more time
anymore.
For tweets, though. But you should send one or two. Just use our hashtag #WakeUpNigeria on TVC.